if you don't love the character of JJ yet, that just sells ya.
So my dad went here, and then his dad went here, and then his dad's dad went here.
That's pretty rough.
Yeah, I know. He would have it hanged for treason.
As a Pogue sympathizer? Mm. Oh my goodness. You've got to be careful fraternizing with the enemy, Valerie. Wait a minute. Did he kidnap you? Or drug you?
No. I can't.
Smooth operator.
Mate, the back and forth. It's the sparks. It's just...
He's really clumsy. He does be...
I'm on a treasure hunt.
What?
He's dead serious, Sarah.
Oh shit, you're serious.
Yeah.
Okay.
Money he made from Tanny helped to buy slaves and give them their freedom. It says that he was accused of inciting revolt. This was before the Civil War.
That's why they hanged him. This is how he bought the land. It's British gold. This is what was on the merchant.
Bingo.
Wow.
This is...
Wait, what's the date on the letter?
It is... May 3rd, 1844. Wait, that's...
That's the day you knew it.
And this is addressed to Robert.
So on the day he dies, he writes a letter to his son?
If you press charges, it'll be out to juvenile court. And Pope is 16. Could be tried as an adult. In due time.
Press charges.
You know, Hayward...
Deputy, I said press charges.
Seriously?
Rude to waiters at a minimum type of thing?
How? That hurts. Yikes.
Just saying.
You know you're not what I expected either. It's much weirder.
So it just fades away.
I'll go back to the bubble.
Like, Topper? Back to the bubble?
Yeah. And, I guess we'll go back to being a fugitive.
So you're gonna break his little heart.
Destruction of property. Put your hands on the counter where I can see it.
Wait. Shoot, what'd he do?
Huh? Take a look at the warrants.
Sorry, you're arresting
him? Just arrest
What's the proof?
Be careful.
Shoot,
are you listening? Anything you say can and will be held against you in the court of law. You have the right.
And Omen John B's not there, yo. Ever think about that too? JJ.
It was me.
Don't.
He tried to talk me out of it.
JJ.
But I was mad because he'd just been beaten up. I'm so sick of his ass.
JJ, what are you doing?
I'm telling the truth. For once in my goddamn life, I'm going to tell the truth. I took his old man's boat, too.
What the hell? JJ, come on.
Just shut. It's just all me.
That's the whole truth. I've heard that about Chris.
If you don't love the character of JJ yet, that just sells ya. 100%, mate. Can someone go and get him? He smiles because he knows he protected his friend.
Now that we... It's been a pleasure working with you, comrade.
Pleasure's mine.
Shoot your shot. Shoot your shot, mate.
You're just gonna walk away like this never happened?
That's what professionals do, right?
If my friends find out, or your boyfriend with this frosty tips, look, yesterday I didn't even know who you were. And today I'm like, Sarah Cameron. Like, this didn't happen. I'm sorry, I sent her.
can't pretend either.
Well, we kind of knew that was going to happen, right?
Yeah.
They're going to sneak around. Wait, that's the compass. And that's the hook that apparently killed those shady key guys. Who are you? Okay. That episode was really fun, but also emotionally character-driven with character development. It's a lot of words, didn't make much sense, but I'll explain. We've got the whole idea of John being really focused on finding out more information because the Royal Merchant had no gold, and I'm very intrigued by the fact that Sarah's family is living in the house that was purchased by the guy that survived the Royal Merchant crash. Like, that's just, whoa, what a twist. But I love how they spent this episode really building that development between Sarah and John that they'd been hinting at that since the first episode, right? That first episode, you could tell that she was interested. He was kind of like looking at her. They didn't know each other, but they just had, there was something there. And then it wasn't until episode 4 that they really showed that, because she just happened to be there when he needed to get a quick getaway. But I loved that whole story because it progressed the main storyline, but also got the character development in there. Like, I just, that creation of that whole thing was awesome. And then you got Pope and JJ. Mate, if you don't love JJ by the end of episode 4, who are you kidding? Like, he literally gave up his freedom for Pope. Because, you know, Pope had more to lose. And JJ just has a reduced amount of, like, opinion on himself that he just went, screw it, I'm going to save my friend. And that's why he smiled at the end. My heart. I love it. I love this. I love it. Oh, I'm so excited. But I'm very interested to see where they go next, because that little pan at the end, there's someone else, someone that we haven't met yet, that is behind the deaths, got the compass. Like, who is this person? I am just, I'm loving this storyline. Really do. I hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. If you did, give a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, make sure to click subscribe. And I realize anything I just said in like the last 3 minutes made no sense at all, but my rambling shows excitement and enjoyment for a show, so I'll see you guys next time. Bye.